song, Bhaktivinod Thakur wrote one song, Sri Nam Kirtan. Nam Kirtan. Jaso Mati Nandana Braja Baranakara Kokula Ranjana Kana. Jaso Mati Nandana Braja Baranakara Kokula
Yamuna Kasajara Gopi Vasanahara. Okay, so we're going to read Bhagavad Gita now.
现在我们继续阅读《国家梵歌》。
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.Bhagavad Gita, chapter 4, Transcendental Knowledge, text number 11.
我们现在阅读《国家梵歌》原译第四章《超然的知识》第十一师节。
Number 12. Yeah, 11 done. Oh, we already did 11. On number 12.
第十二世界
Kanshanta Kalmana Siddhim
Kanshanta
Kalmana Siddhim Yajanta Iha DevataYajanta iha devata Shipram hi manushe loke
Shipram hi manushe loke
Siddhir bhavati karma cha Siddhir bhavati karma cha
Siddhir bhavati karma cha
Kanshanta karmanam siddhim
Kanshanta karmanam siddhim
Yajanta iha devata
Yajanta iha devata
Shipram hi manushe loke
Shipram hi manushe loke
Siddhir bhavati karma cha
Siddhir bhavati karma cha
Kanshanta karmana siddhim
Kanshanta karmana siddhim
Yajanta iha devata
Yajanta iha devata
Shibramhi manushe loke
Shibramhi manushe
bhavati karma cha.
Sirye bhavati karma cha.
Kamshanta kammanam siddhim.
Kamshanta kammanam siddhim.
Yajanta iha devata.
Yajanta iha devata.
Sivrahi manushe loke.
They worship by sacrifices. Iha, in the material world. Devata, the demigods. Shipram,
very quickly.
He, certainly.
Manushe,
in human society. Loke, within this world. Siddhi,
success.
Bhavati comes. Karmaja, from fruit of work. Translation. Men in this world desire success in fruit of activities, and therefore they worship the demigods. Quickly, of course, men get results from fruitive work in this world.
译文：人在这世上从事公益性活动，渴望成功，因此就去崇拜半神人。当然，他们很快就会从公益性活动中得到结果。
Purport. There is a great misconception about the gods or demigods of this material world, and men of less intelligence, although passing as great scholars, take these demigods to be various forms of the Supreme Lord. You can read the Chinese.
Yes. 要指人们对这个物质世界的神明或半神人存在着一个极大的概念错误。智力较差的人虽然貌似大学问家，也都把这些半神人误认作至尊主的不同形体。
Actually, the demigods are not different forms of God, but they are God's different parts and parcels.
实际上，半神人并不是神的不同形体，而是神不同的所属部分。
God is one, and the parts and parcels are many.
神只有一位。而其所属个体就数目繁多了。
The Vedas say, Nityo Nityanam, God is one. Ishvara Paramakrishna.
韦达经说 Nityo Nityanam, 神只有一位。Ishvara Paramakrishna.
The Supreme God is one, Krishna, and the demigods are delegated with powers to manage this material world.
至尊神只有一位 Krishna， 而半神人则被授权管理这个物质世界。
These demigods are all living entities, Nityanam, with different grades of material power.
这些半神人全是生物 Nityanam， 拥有的物质能力也各不相同。
They cannot be equal to the Supreme God, Narayan, Vishnu, or Krishna.
他们不可能等同于至尊神 Narayana, Vishnu 或 Krishna.
Anyone who thinks that God and the demigods are on the same level is called an atheist or Pashandi.
凡认为神和半神人在同一层次的就是无神论者 Pashandi.
Even the great demigods like Brahma and Shiva cannot be compared to the Supreme Lord.
即使是 Brahma 和 Shiva 这样伟大的半神人，也不能与至尊主相比。
In fact, the Lord is worshipped by demigods such as Brahma and Shiva.
其实，像 Brahma 和 Shiva 的半神人也是崇奉主的。
Yet, curiously enough, there are many human leaders who are worshipped by foolish men under the misunderstanding of.Anthropomorphism or geomorphism.
可是愚昧的人受神人同行和受行神论的错误观点的影响，竟崇奉起许多人类的领袖们来，真是奇怪。
Yeah, David Dardanes, a powerful man or demigod of this material world.
伊哈德瓦塔哈是指有大能的人或这个物质世界里的半神人。
But Narayan, Vishnu, or Krishna, the supreme personality of Godhead, does not belong to this material world.
而南人亚纳、维什努或至尊人格首神 Krishna 并不属于这个世界。
He is above or transcendental to material creation.
他在物质创造之上或超然于物质创造。
So we want to understand this verse carefully.
我们想要非常仔细地理解这个世界。
We see here in Malaysia that many people worship the demigods.
我们看到在马来西亚这里有很多的人崇拜半神人。
And why do they worship the demigods?
他们为什么会崇拜半神人呢?
They want to get some material benefit.
因为他们想要得到一些物质的好处。
Somebody wants to go to heaven in the next life.
有的人想要下一世去天堂。
Somebody wants to be successful in their material life in this life.
有的人呢想在这一生当中取得物质上的成功。
They have many different desires.
所以他们有很多不同的愿望。
And they find that by worshipping some demigod.They can get results quickly.
他们就发现， 他们就发现呢，如果他们就是崇拜半圣人的话，他们很快就会得到结果。
It's tempting to people to hear about this. People will be tempted. They want to do this.
人们呢就想要去这么去做，去崇拜半圣人。
They'll think, oh, maybe I should also do this.
他们就会想呢，也许我也应该这么做。
I want to get money. I should worship Lakshmi.
如果我想得到钱的话，我就去崇拜 Lakshmi 幸运女神。
And a lot of people worship Lakshmi to get money.
有很多的人就是崇拜 Lakshmi 只是为了得到金钱。
But they forget that Lakshmi is also another name of Lakshmi is Chanchal. That she is restless.
但是呢，他们忘记了 Lakshmi 女神有另外一个名字叫 Chanchala， 意思是她是躁动不安的。
That you may get Lakshmi, but you can't keep it for very long.
你也许得到了 Lakshmi， 但是呢，你无法把它长久的保留住。
You go shopping and spend all the money.
你们去购物的时候就会花掉所有的钱。
Or you think I'll do investment?And you lose everything.
然后呢，你去做投资，然后结果就亏本了。
Because we're thinking, I've got money, I'll make it grow, I'll make it expand, I'll double my money.
因为你总是在想，一旦我得到了钱，那我就想把这个钱，得到更多的钱，让这个钱扩张。
And you lose everything.
结果呢，你却亏了，就失去了一切。
So that's one of the problems which come when you worship.The demigods.
所以呢，这就是崇拜半神人所伴随而来的一些问题。
You may worship Lord Shiva to get a good husband.
你也许会崇拜主希瓦，为了得到一个好的丈夫。
You may get a good husband, but you may not have any money.
你也许得到了一个好的丈夫，但是你却没有钱。
The husband may not have a job.
这个丈夫呢可能是没有工作的。
Or you may get sick.
或者是呢你会生病。
So many problems come in material life.
所以在物质生活当中总是会有很多的问题会到来。
So we have to understand the nature of the material world.
我们要理解到就是物质世界的本性。
That there will always be problems.
物质世界里总是充满各种问题。
And the real problem is birth, old age, disease, and death.
而真正的问题是生老病死。
And the only person who can solve that problem is when you worship the Supreme Lord.
唯一能够解决这一问题的方法就是当你崇拜至尊主。
Because the demigods, they also suffer old age, disease, and death.
因为半神人他也是受制于生老病死的痛苦。
Well, not so much disease, but they do get old and they do have to give up their body.
他们也许不会生病，但是呢，他们确实会变老，然后最终会死亡，放弃躯体。
So Srila Prabhupada describes it as a very common misunderstanding for people in the material world to think that the demigods are the same as the Supreme Lord.
所以Srila Prabhupada在这个要旨里面说到呢，一般的人都认为这个半神人都和至尊主平等。
That people think all the gods are one, it's all the same.
人们认为呢，所有的这些神都是一样的，都是相同的。
I was in Govardhan, and it was Parikrama. We were doing Parikrama around the Govardhan Hill. It was the full moon night.
我在哥瓦丹的时候，然后我们在一个满月的时候做哥瓦丹山的绕拜。
There's always more people on Parikrama around the Govardhan Hill on the full moon.
在满月的时候呢，总是会有更多的人前来做哥瓦丹山的绕拜。
So I was walking, and then somehow I began to talk with this one man, and I said to him, I asked him, "Where are you from?" He said, "I'm from Jaipur. Jaipur is quite."It's a few hours away from Vrindavan.
然后我当时呢正在走路，然后就遇到一个人，我就问他你是从哪儿来，然后那个人回答说我是来自于 Jaipur 那个地方，离Vrindavan还挺远的。
And I said, oh, do you come here often? He said, every Purnima, it means every month you will come to the due parikrama of the Govardhan Hill.
然后他就说呢，他每个月的满月的时候呢，都会来到哥瓦丹山来做这个哥瓦丹山的绕拜。
So I said to him, "Oh, you must be a great devotee of Lord Krishna."
然后我就对他说，哦，你一定是主 Krishna 一位伟大的奉献者。
He said, "Yes, not only Krishna, I'm a devotee of all the gods."
然后他就回答说，是的，我是 Krishna 的奉献者，不仅仅是 Krishna 的奉献者，我是所有神的奉献者。
So then I understood. Oh.
然后我就明白了。哦。
Mayavada.
他们是 Mayavada.
This is not our teaching.
这不是我们的教导。
But this is a common understanding of people.
但是呢，这却是这个一般人很常见的一个理解的概念。
If you go to the temples, the Hindu temples, you'll see they have many gods.
如果你们去印度教的这些庙宇里面，你们就会看到那个庙里面有很多的神像。
And if you ask them which one is the supreme,
然后你会问他们，你问他们，如果其中哪一个神像是至尊的呢
？They will say they're all the supreme, they're all the God.
他们会回答说，他们都是至尊，他们都是神。
But this is not what Lord Krishna says.
但是这不是 Krishna 所说的。
It says, and from this Bhagavad Gita, we are learning that the different devas are just a part of God.
在不加梵歌里开始，我们就学习到半圣人只是至尊主 Krishna 的碎片部分。
Just like the sun is like the eye of the Supreme Lord.
就像这个太阳，太阳就好比是至尊主的眼睛。
The different part, the different demigod.Just like even we are also part of the body of the Supreme Lord.
我们呢也是至尊主，他的这个身体当中的一部分。
The Brahmanas are like the head.
Brahmana 就好比是头部。
The Kshatriya are the arms.
Kshatriya 好比是胳膊。
The Vaishya are the belly.
Vaishya 是肚腹。
And the Sudra are the legs.
Sudra 是双腿。
So we are all part of the body of the Lord.
所以呢，我们都是主的身体的一部分。
But there's a difference between the part and the whole.
但是呢，部分和整体是有区别的。
So there's one supreme, and there are many others who are his servants.
所以呢，至尊主只有一个，他其他的所属部分呢有很多，都是他的仆人。
How many devas are there? It said there are 330 million devas.
有多少名半神人呢？有3200万的半神人。
330 million. Okay, so these demigods, they all have different powers to help in managing the world.
所以这些半神人，他们都拥有各自不同的力量。来协助管理这个物质宇宙。
But they're not equal to Vishnu or Krishna.
但是呢，他们不能与 Vishnu 或 Krishna 平等。
And if we think they're equal, then that's atheism.
如果我们认为他们是平等的话，那这就是无神论。
And even Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva are not equal to Krishna, to Vishnu or Krishna.
甚至是 Brahma 或 Shiva 也不能等同于主 Vishnu 或 Krishna.
Every morning we are greeting the deities and we sing Lord Brahma's prayer to Krishna.
我们每天早上在敬见神像的时候都会唱诵一首祷文，这个祷文是主 Brahma 对 Krishna 的祈祷。
And Lord Brahma sing Govindam Adi Purusham Tamaham Vrajami.
Brahma.祈祷说 Govinda Adi Purusham Tamaham Vrajami.
So Lord Brahma is worshipping Govinda.
主 Brahma 呢，他是在崇拜主 Govinda.
And Lord Shiva also worships Govinda.
Shiva 也崇拜主 Govinda.
Lord Shiva told his wife, Rame Rame Naropnamo Rame Sahasranam Abhistoyam Shri Ramanama Varanini.Lord Shiva, his wife was going to recite Vishnu Sahasranam. She wanted to say the 1,000 names of Lord Vishnu.
这个祷文这一句话呢是希瓦对他的妻子所说的。他的妻子呢想要念诵 Vishnu 的108个名字，1008个名字，
一千，就有一千，
啊，一千个名字
，1000，
sorry， 是他的妻子想要念诵主威士奴的1000个名字。
And Lord Shiva tells her, you don't need to chant all the names of Vishnu, just chant Lord Rama's name, the name of Lord Rama, one name is equal to 1000 names of Vishnu.
然后希瓦就对他的妻子说到呢，你不需要唱诵主威士奴的1000个名字，你只需要唱诵一次 Rama 的名字，因为一次主 Rama 的名字就相当于1000个主威士奴的名字。
And Lord Shiva also told his wife, Aradhanam Sarvesham Vishnor Aradhanam Param. Of all kinds of worship, the worship of Vishnu is supreme.
希瓦呢也对他的妻子说道，在所有的崇拜当中，崇拜 Narayana 是最高的。
Lord Shiva takes the water of the Ganges on his head.
主希瓦呢，把那个恒河水顶在他的头顶。
That water of the Ganges is the bath water from the lotus feet of Vishnu.
啊，这个恒河水呢，是沐浴过主威士奴莲花足的水。
So Lord Shiva takes that water on his head. He holds it on his head.
所以呢，主希瓦就把这个水顶在他的头顶。
And this way, Lord Shiva is showing us how to respect Lord Vishnu, Lord Krishna, Lord Rama.
就像这样呢，主希瓦呢，他就展示了我们应该如何尊重主 Vishnu 和主 Krishna.
But still, people are not very intelligent, and they don't understand the position of the Supreme Lord.
但是呢，一般的人都没有什么智慧，他们无法理解至尊主的地位。
So Prabhupada quotes about Shankaracharya.
所以泡泡的引述了 Shankaracharya 的引言。
Shankaracharya was he is the leader of the impersonalists.
Shankaracharya 他是非人格主义者的领袖。
But he said also Narayana Parovyakta that Lord Narayan.Is transcendental to the material world.
但他同时也说，主 Narayana 是超然于物质世界之上的。
Why do people worship the devas?
人们为什么会崇拜 devata 半神人呢？
They want to get the results, and they know they will get result quick.
因为他们想得到这个物质的结果，而且他们也知道他们很快就会得到结果。
But they forget that the results.Will be temporary.
但是他们忘记了一点，就是这个结果是短暂的。
You may get health, but how long will you be healthy for?
你也许会得到健康，但是呢，你能保持这个健康多长时间呢？
You're going to still die one day.
你总有一天会死掉的。
You're going to get money, maybe you will get money, but how long will you keep it?
你也许会得到了钱财，但是呢？这个钱财能保持多长时间呢？
Many people, many students, they will worship Saraswati to pass the exam.
有很多的学生就是崇拜 Saraswati 女神，为了通过考试。
But then there will be another exam.
但是呢，还有下一次的考试。
There's so many endless exams.
有无止境的考试。
If you become a doctor.Exams, every year they have to have another exam.
如果你是医生的话，那每一年都会有考试。
So intelligent people, they will worship the Supreme Lord.
所以有智慧的人会崇拜至尊主。
A devotee of Krishna is not interested in anything material.
Krishna 的奉献者对任何物质的东西都不感兴趣。
Because the results are material and temporary.
因为这个结果是物质的，是短暂的。
Prabhupada compares the results of their worship. He said, just like bubbles in the sea.
帕帕德把他们的这种对半神人的崇拜比作成海洋中的泡沫。
So the bubble is very, it's only there for a short, very short time of worship.
所以这个泡沫它是转瞬即逝的。
So Some people want to be successful in politics. When the election comes, they will campaign to win the election.
有的人呢，就是想要取得政治上的成功。当选举到来的时候呢，他们，
So if they win the election, then they're very happy. They worship the demigod to get that good result.
就是当这个选举的时候到来的时候呢，他们就去崇拜半神人，然后他们想要得到这个好的结果。
So they waste their time. They win the election, and then after some time, then they lose. They get kicked out.
这个 就只是浪费时间，他们也许就是参加了这个选举，但是一段时间之后呢，他们又失败了。
So Prabhupada said this verse is telling us that there are not many people interested in Krishna consciousness.
所以帕瓦德在这个世界的要旨当中告诉我们，并不是有很多的人对 Krishna 知觉感兴趣。
Because most people are interested in material enjoyment.
因为大部分的人都只是对物质享乐感兴趣
，so they will worship some powerful living entity.
所以呢，他们就会去崇拜一些非常有力量的生物体。
They'd rather worship some ordinary man rather than Krishna.
他们宁愿去崇拜一个普通的半神人，而不是崇拜 Krishna.
If somebody will help us become very rich, then we will worship him.
就如果有的人变得非常的富有的话，那些人就会去崇拜他。
Prabhupada said he remembers during the war time in India. During the war, Shudhir Dasam.
所以呢，帕瓦帕有次说到，就是在世界大战的时候。
He said there was one businessman he worshipped Hitler.
就有一个做生意的人，他崇拜希特勒。
Because he made so much money doing business, selling things during the war.
因为他在那个战时的时候，就在战争的时候，他就这样倒卖东西，赚了很多的钱。
So, any question?
有没有问题？
Yes.
顶拜咕噜队，顶拜各位奉献者，我的问题是，为什么崇拜希瓦的人都非常非常富有，而崇拜主 Krishna 的人，很多处于一种一无所有的状态，是不是 Krishna 要把我们所有的这种物质欲望拿走，让我们更好的去修行？我不知道这样理解对不对，还是 Krishna？
Why the people who worship Lord Shiva is very rich, but the people who worship Lord Krishna is very poor or even have nothing? Is that because Krishna wants to take away our material desires so that we can practice better?
This is explained in the 10th canto Srimad Bhagavatam towards the end of the 10th canto.
就是这一点在圣典薄伽瓦堂的第十篇的末尾的地方有过解释。
It said the devotees of Lord Shiva, they may have what seems like material opulence.
其中说到呢，主希瓦的奉献者也许看上去拥有物质的富裕。
But they don't have peace or real happiness.
但是呢，他们的心中没有和平，没有真正的快乐。
They're always angry and passionate.
他们总是充满了愤怒，充满了激情。
Full of lust and pride.
他们总是充满了色欲，满是骄傲。
The devotees of Krishna may not have so much wealth.
Krishna 的奉献者也许没有那么多的富裕。
But they enjoy spiritual peace.
但是呢，他们享受着灵性的平和。
They have control over their mind and senses.
他们控制了感官和心意。
They're situated in the mode of goodness.
他们稳处在善良心态当中。
So they have a special opulence.
所以他们拥有的这种富裕是特殊的富裕。
They're satisfied with whatever is given to them by the grace of God.
他们满足于凭借着至尊主的仁慈而到来的一切。
And they have the holy name to chant.
他们也有圣名可以唱诵。
And they're happy to chant the holy name.
他们唱诵圣名是非常快乐的。
They don't want to go to that big restaurant there next door.
They got to go to the big restaurant next door.
他们不想要去那个隔壁的那个大餐馆。
There's nothing in that place for us.
那种地方没有什么是让我们感到吸引的。
There's nothing good to eat.
也没有什么好吃的东西。
There's nothing good to do there.
没有什么的好事情在那里可以做。
We're happy to come here.
我们来到这里非常的开心。
And chant and dance.
在这里唱诵跳舞。
And take some simple prasad.
荣耀一些简单的菩萨的
That is our opulence.
这就是我们的富裕
Yes, Bhadra, what did
you? 今天你们买很多阿威买回这么足啊哎阿威买完掉
Hare Krishna 顶拜咕噜队顶拜所有的奉献者我的问题是请教咕噜我们都知道主希望是主奎士达纯粹奉献者那他为什么不叫到他的门徒他的奉献者去崇拜奎士达呢
Why does Lord Shiva not tell his disciples to worship Krishna since Lord Shiva is such a great devotee? Well, he does in the Srimad Bhagavatam we were just reading about the Prachetas and Lord Shiva came and gave them the song which he had written to worship the Supreme Lord.
主希瓦他是教导的我们正在阅读圣典国家瓦坛里面的一个章节这个主希瓦在教导那个帕西坦他们去崇拜至尊主。
So those who are real people, genuine people who are serious about spiritual truth, Lord Shiva will give his real mercy to them. He will teach them about the worship of the Supreme Lord.
如果一个普通人对这个灵性真理的追求是认真的话，那么主希瓦也会就是给予他指导，然后教他崇拜至尊主。
He told his wife to worship, to chant the name of Ram, and to worship Vishnu.
他告诉他的妻子来唱诵主 Rama 的圣名。
But these other people, you're a rascal, you know, they want some material blessing. So Lord Shiva said, okay, yes, yeah. You want this, oh, okay, yes. He will give the material blessing. He doesn't want to be troubled with them.
但是如果一个人他只是对物质的东西感兴趣的话，那么主希瓦就会说 okay, 那就给你吧。但是呢，就是不会给他们一些灵性上的这样的东西。
So he has two potencies. One is his cheating potency, and one is his real, the highest potency.
所以呢，这有两种能量，一种是欺骗的能量，而另外一种呢是更高级的一种能量。
There's a parampara coming from Lord Shiva.
这个有一个主来自于主希瓦的 parampara 的传系。
So he has his own disciplic succession where he's giving knowledge about the Supreme Lord.
主希瓦他是有他自己的传系的，在他的那个传系当中，他会给予有关至尊主的讯息。
But for common people who come with their material desires, he won't waste time with them.
但是呢，如果就是对于那些怀着物质动机来接近他的一些普通人的话，他就会就是会满足他的愿望，然后让那些人不要打扰他。
Let them learn for themselves, learn the hard way.
让他们自己去学习吧，让他们以一种艰难的方式让他们自己去学习。
Okay, Hare Krishna. Okay, last question. All right, what's your question, Prabhu?
Hare Krishna Prabhu. Prabhu, my age is now 28. my question is, this spiritual awakening, this consciousness, is this fate or is it what me, the soul, are looking for? And if I want to stay in the path of Dharma, is it possible in this age?
To stay in the path of Dharma in this age, what do I, he wants, what Dhamnang Weisi links in the Shangha, Sai Chiganin Dai. So, it's possible, yes, definitely possible. If you come and stay in this temple.
如果你来这个庙里面参加节目,
you have to join the Krishna Consciousness Movement.
你要加入Krishna知觉运动,
and then when you join the Krishna Consciousness Movement, then you can stay in Dharma.
如果你加入这个Krishna知觉运动, 你就可以, 保持在这个Dharma之中。
You have to surrender to Krishna.
要向Krishna皈依。
You have to get association with devotees.
要和奉献者们联谊。
You have to be with people who are practicing Dharma.
你要和那些正在修习、实践Dharma的人和他们在一起。
If you associate with meat eaters and drunkards, you will become a meat eater and drunkard.
如果你和肉食者和酒鬼联谊的话，你也会变成肉食者和酒鬼。
But if you associate with the devotees, you'll become a saintly devotee.
如果你和奉献者联谊的话，你也会变成圣洁的奉献者。
So you have to understand the importance of association.
你要知道这个联谊是非常重要的。
You have to come regularly.
你要经常的来到庙宇，有规律的来庙宇。
You have to do service.
在这里做一些服务。
Then you can learn what is Dharma.
然后你就会学习到什么是Dharma。
You understand? Okay. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Gita ki.
Jai.
Premanande.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.